So now I'm gonna show you how to right the wheelchair once you've fallen. We teach this because everyone is bound to fall at some point. Things that might hinder their success with this is if they have decreased hip or trunk range of motion, which doesn't allow them to get into the positions they need, decreased upper extremity strength, as well as the tippiness of the chair can affect how successful they are. So the less tippy the chair is, the more successful they'll be, the easier it is to flip it back up. People that we wouldn't do this with are people who, again, have significant wounds, as getting into the position to practice this isn't the best for those, as well as if they have a cervical collar or TLSO. So with that, I'll now demonstrate how to do the skill. So once you're in this position, you need to make sure that you're holding onto the frame, as if you try to hold onto the wheels, the wheelchair will spin. What you're gonna do is lock the brake, come over, you'll again lock the other brake, and then coming back, once you're here, one hand is gonna continue to grip the frame as the other hand comes down. You're gonna initially lock out the arm, and then as you go, you're gonna walk the whole way around, and you're pushing down with the other hand that's on the frame. But you can see how far over I was in the wheelchair to be able to perform that. So that's where the range of motion comes into play. Ways to make this easier, like I said, if you decrease the tippiness of the chair, it'll be easier for the patient to come up. You can remove the cushion to bring the patient lower to the floor, or you can also use a bump up, which you'll see in the next video.